guys, welcome to another Byron Sunday Sessions, and my special guest and good friend is Ash Grunwald.
Hey mate. Hey Petey, how you going?
Welcome to my studio.
Hi everyone.
It was too windy outside today. Normally we do this up around my fireplace.
Right.
But it was blowing a gale, so we decided to come into the studio today.
It's nice.
Yeah.
Super nice.
Which concerns me a little bit because your voice is so loud. I was thinking I might have to place you over in the back corner there.
Oh just, my god, know, yeah.
Sing a little softer today, mate.
I need to learn that. I do need to learn that.
You got a hell of a voice, I tell you.
It's loud. It is loud. You know, I would have been good in the old days, you know, with Delta Blues and stuff, because you know they used to have like national steels like this, no amplification. These are really loud, and then if you had a loud voice, you were set.
Where did you grow up?
I grew up in the eastern suburbs of Melbourne.
Yep.
And I learned guitar from my granddad and did lessons and stuff from the age of about 10. My family's from South Africa on that side of the family. They're like, they're called like Cape Town, they're Cape Coloureds. So he looked very bluesy. He played some jazzy stuff.
Okay.
But I mean, I always wonder if that's why I went down the blues kind of path. Like black American music always just really appealed to me.
Yeah.
I grew up in a very, very sort of just Anglo Aussie area.
Yeah.
So that side of my family were the odd ones out. So maybe that led me down that path. But I did, I used to play bass for my granddad and he used to record a lot and stuff like that, just in his studio, his back, his own studio. But he was actually a chippy. I mentioned him in my song Hammer that we're going to jam.
Oh, right, okay.
In the start of that.
But we're going to play two songs, one of yours, and then you're going to jam on one of mine. But talking about blues, now I read on your socials the other day that misconception of blues and how the, you know, how it's kind of, it's not necessarily sad music.
Well, yeah, massive PR nightmare to have blues. You know, it's like, oh, I've got the blues. I'm about to commit my suicide, or you know, like, I'm blue. I'm depressed. I think that is part of blues, of some blues, but really, I think blues is about transcending your current state. Like even the lyrics, they might be sad, but the feeling that comes out is almost like this this release.
Yeah.
You know, when you play it and when you hear it and when it's really soulful, you're just like, yeah, you know, and it's sort of, it's exercising your demons, or it's getting it out, you know, and well, as you probably know with my stuff too, which is like the original blues. It's actually for partying too.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't feel sad when I'm listening to your music. It's definitely pretty pumped up and it's good fun.
Yeah, and it's actually when I got to know more about the historical context of blues, I realized it was just generally what I was doing, traveling around Australia, playing in every one horse town and festivals and whatever, just trying to pump people up. That is actually what 90% of blues musicians were doing, traveling around and, you know, getting people want to forget their problems.
Yep.
But then, you know, you do have your slow 12 bar blues and stuff, but I like that too, just when I do that, I try and slow the guitar down. It's not really about the beat anymore. And I just try and soar with the vocals. It's more about going somewhere different, you know, with it.
Well, look, your music's not sad. And you as a person, you're not sad either. Like you're one of the most positive, jovial people I've ever met. And we've had a I met you first in, I think it was 2004, Cockatoo Island Festival, I think it was.
Yeah.
And I was walking up the steps. I don't know if you remember this. We bumped into each other. You were walking down the steps.
Yeah.
I was on my way up in my career. You might have been on your way down. But you were super polite.
Yeah.
And I remember remembering that meeting, just really brief.
Mm.
And then it was about probably 2 or 3 months later, I got you on my tour to support me.
Yeah,
which was great fun.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did some
probably
great
too much
gigs.
Fun, actually.
Yeah. It was a lot of too much fun back in the day.
I know. Listen, let's do this song of yours. This one's called Hammer.
Yeah.
So this is, you mentioned your grandfather in this track.
Yeah, well, yeah, I come from a line of builders, actually. Okay. So that's why some guy in the surf yesterday said to me, were you really born with a hammer in your hand? but, you know, that song was influenced a lot by, there's an old field holler, an American song about the Ballad of John Henry, a guy who was working on the railroads, was born with a hammer in his hand. And I was working with that kind of stuff. I was actually teaching the kids about that stuff and I sort of applied it to my life.
Right.
And so So I came up with this little number.
Well,
let's do it.
Let's do it. Let's get comfy first on this couch.
Okay.
This is
yeah.
I'm sinking.
Well, well, well. Young man on the building side, I rest my feet in smoke cold. My granddaddy looked at his watch and he said, boys, I think it's time to strike a blow. I was born with a hammer in my hand, and I died with a hammer in my hand. I was born with a hammer in my hand, and I died with a hammer in my hand. They say give a child a hammer, whoa, become a name, and I'll die with a hammer in my hand. Whoa. Trying to put wind in the sail out of Bentley. No, we had to call a dawn's party out at Doubtful Creek. And I could still remember when I had a paddle of old condom mine. The gas is all around. Thinking to myself, oh, nobody tried to spark a light. I was born with a hammer in my hand, and I died with a hammer in my hand. I was born with a hammer in my hand, and I died with a hammer in my hand. They say give a child a hammer, whoa, become a name, and I'll die with a hammer in my hand. They say give a child a hammer, whoa, become a name, and I'll die with a hammer in my hand. They say give a child a hammer, whoa, become a name, and I'll die with a hammer.